Hello, I'm Todd Lewis from Fiasco Sports, reporting for the SA Footballer magazine, and today I'm joined by Rick Pearce from the Portland Football Club, and he's our featured coach of the week, so we're going to find a little bit about him. So, Rick, where have you coached in the past and also played your junior footy? I'm sure you've probably got a lot of experience coaching a Div 1 football side.
Originally come from country Victoria, got recruited across to Norwood back in the 80, was it 83, played 4 years at Norwood. Then went back home, captain coached through the country football divisions for a few years over there. Moved back to Adelaide in 1990 and sort of stepped away from football, concentrated on having my own work and business, but got back involved in at Henley with Scotty Hodges, going back about 11 or 12 years ago as his assistant and just getting back into the game. Then I coached at Port Districts for 5 years, and the last 5 years at Portland.
Okay, that's good. So have you won flags and stuff then? Because you've obviously got a lot of experience. You've been coaching for a little while. So have you had any premiership success, or is that still in the future plans?
Been really lucky. I've had 13 premierships.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, country football in '82, got three at Norwood. I've been fortunate all the way through with premierships. It's say something that just seemed to follow me, so I'm quite lucky.
Yeah, so let's hope that culture comes to Paul and then. Also, just tell us a little bit about your team this year. Obviously, you said you didn't lose any players, so have you brought a few in or?
Yeah, oh, we've lost two. We lost young Sam Pendle, who's
Okay.
gone home to country football, and Shane Harris has gone to Seton. But what we got back, we've got Brett Pryor, who's missed last year with the injury. The knee reconstruction. We've got Ryan Richter who's come on board. We've got Josh Moody on board. We've got young Dale Finney. Plus, we've got four or five guys who only played between five and seven games last year due to work commitments and going overseas. They're all full time this year. So, what we've developed now is a team that's a lot more depth, and there's going to be a lot of good footballers running around the B grade. So, it's the exciting times for the football club.
Okay, so what would you say your style of game you're looking to implement without giving too much away? Just what are you looking for the boys to give week in, week out?
100% simple. What we do, we create turnovers with our speed. We've got a pretty good rebounding side. We pride ourselves on the 50-50 contest with the ball on the ground, of getting it back or creating another stoppage. Our structures are pretty simple, but if we stick to them, it does create a lot of goal opportunities. Our forward line has got a bit of strength about it, and it's also got a bit of excitement about it, that X factor. So, happy through the midfield, happy through the forwards, and our back six are really solid. Our back six go down the back. We probably bat down to eight or nine. We're a really good group that can fit roll through there. And in today's football, you've got to be able to move and spread. So, once we get our hands onto it, we've got a pretty good idea where we're going with it next. So, that makes a big difference.
Okay, that's nice. So going back onto your own coaching, is there anyone you sort of model yourself on or have gained inspiration from in the past from maybe a higher level, say AFL or SANFL?
Probably the biggest influence was a guy called Jared Fitzgerald, who coaches Ballarat now. He played a bit of football at Geelong. He took hold of me when I was 15, when I first played my first senior game, and developed an understanding of the game, and that it wasn't just go out and get a kick. It was why you got a kick, and everything had to be plus one or plus two. So where you got it went, or where if you're going to go somewhere and get on the end of it, you had to understand why you're getting there. You just didn't run around chasing it like a sheepdog.
Yeah.
So he gave me that guidance early. Neil Barm was obviously impressive.
Oh, okay.
4 years at Norwood under Barmy, and he pointed us in the right direction. Scotty Hodges had really great ideas coming through the 90s, and his football was at elite level. You learn from everyone, I reckon. You learn from your C grade coaches, your B grade coaches, and just watching a game of football. So I think we all should be students of the game, protect the game, and encourage the game to be better again.
Yeah, okay. So also you've been coaching for a fair while, so I'm just thinking what gives you the joy of coaching? You've been doing it for so long. What's the thing that keeps you coming back?
The passion of it. I reckon the players, the people that go every week and watch the game of football, the involvement. There's nothing I think greater than being involved in a team sport. Guys just paying each other out on the training track, pushing them past places they've never been. I can't do it, and all of a sudden they've done it. Sam Graham from football is like, you look at our guys 5 years ago. We're talking Divvy Four. Now we run around Divvy One. That's the highest football they've ever played. No, they're not reserves footballers or league footballers. They're footballers that we've grown and coached, and they stay together. So that's what I enjoy.
Yeah, and just tell us a little bit about some of your key players. So maybe your leadership group and some key players that you really not rely on but look to on a weekend to stand up and lead you home, basically.
Our captain for the last year, 4 years, has been Dale Lazlett. He's just got that uncanny ability to create turnovers, get to someone and tackle that you don't believe someone should get there. He has that ability to get there. Jared Waring through the middle of the ground, who's on left side, right side, is stoppage work, is up there with the best in the competition. Brett Pryor coming back from knee this year, he's just a super footballer, be forward, be back. Guys like Josh Draper down back, who's just got that uncanny ability to get the left hand in to make a spoil. Robbie Wilson, who's just, his father's a president of the football club. I think he's into his nearly 200th game of football at the football club. And just that ability and the hunger they have just to play football with each other.
Yep. Okay, so just talking a little bit about the club now, is there anyone, any major sponsors or sponsors you'd like to put out there? And have you got any functions coming up also that you'd like to give a bit of a promotion?
Definitely. Well, Chemist King is one of our major sponsors. I know Program are involved in the football club. The Alberton Hotel is involved in the football club. Total Design, which is a, I think it's the little web setup that Tommy Oates, one of our players, is mixed up in, who's great for the football club and does our homepage for all our promotions. Yeah, you look at Ladies' Day, I think we first two games away, then we have our first home game is at home. That's Ladies' Day. We have a ball throughout the year. We have a lot of functions. That's one thing we do very well.
Yeah. Okay, so it's obviously a good club culture around here. That's probably part of the reason you've stuck around as well.
It is. It's they need to be encouraged to leave late on Saturday nights to go to the next function so the volunteers can pack the bar up and so forth. It is. It's a good place to be. It's not unfamiliar to a country club where I come from, where that's the lifeline of the community. It's a really inviting place to stay around and have a drink and then try and get home.
Yeah, nice. Okay, well, thanks, Rick. I'm Todd Lewis from Fiasco Sports, reporting for the SA Footballer magazine. Rick Pearce from the Portland Football Club has been our feature coach of the week.